Today I'm going to show you how to photograph the stars and the Milky Way with the camera phone. Now your results will vary depending on what camera phone you have, but if you have either the Huawei P20 Pro, P30 Pro or P40 Pro, or the latest iPhone, which I think at the moment is the iPhone 11, you should be able to get some great results with these phones. It does take some setting up and you will have to be patient, but if you are, you'll be surprised at what you can get. I certainly was, and even though it's not on the same level as my Sony a7 III, it does an amazing job for the size of sensor and the fact that it is actually a camera phone. The first thing you need to do is get your phone stabilized as the exposures will be really long. I put mine on a camera tripod with a phone holder, but most small tripods will do, or even a gorilla pod or a mini tripod on a flat surface. Also, make sure the phone holder is sturdy. I had my phone drop out of one the other day, so I had to buy one that's much better and that really gripped the phone well. The last thing you want is your phone falling on the floor and breaking. To find a good location, if you're in a big city, you'll probably already know that there won't be many stars to see there, so you really need to get away from any lights or any light pollution. There is a scale called the Bortle scale, and it determines how much light there is in a given area. So find your location on this map at lightpollutionmap.info and look for the darker colors near you. Then work out the best way to get to that location, and then work out when there's going to be a new moon and when it's going to be a clear night on the weather forecast. And that's the time you want to get there. So basically, when there's no moon, you'll see a lot more stars. And if the Milky Way is in your sky at the time that you want to go there, you'll see this Milky Way. If it's a full moon, the brightness from that moon will bleach out all of these stars and the Milky Way. To work this out, just Google new moon time and type in your location, and it should give you the days in the current month when there'll be a new moon. It basically happens once a month over about 5 days, from when there's not much light shining on the moon to the new moon to when that moon starts brightening up again from all of that sunlight hitting the moon. The less moonlight there is, the more stars that you'll be able to see. Now, if you want to get the Milky Way in your shot, you need to know where it is in the sky and when it will be in your sky. I use an app called PhotoPills that shows exactly where it will be and at what time. With the augmented reality view, you can almost work out your shot before heading out to that location. But basically, between April and September through the Northern Hemisphere summer, this is when the Milky Way will be up in the sky at night. Between October and March, it's in the sky in the daytime, so this is the time to avoid if you're wanting to photograph the Milky Way. Once you have all of that sorted, you've waited for one of those clear nights on a new moon, and you're at the location that you've chosen, and you have your phone on the tripod to stabilize it, you need to set the phone up in the right way. I'm using the P30 Pro from Huawei, but if you have the most modern iPhone, that will probably do as well. You just need to be in the manual settings, so you get to change all of the settings from your ISO to your aperture to your shutter speed. On the P30 Pro, you need to go into your Pro settings and then bring them all out of auto. This is because you need control over all of the settings, so getting them out of auto is the first step. Also, with the P30 Pro, each of the cameras on the phone have different ISO levels. This is just basically how sensitive the sensor can go. If you switch to the wide camera on the P30 Pro, it actually has a smaller aperture. As well as this, the ISO is limited to 3200, so you will get a darker, noisier shot with this wide lens camera. So the best option is to switch to the ×1 camera, and this will give you ISO levels up to 409,600. However, this is where the camera gets a little bit quirky. If you keep it to 6400 or lower, you have access to all of these settings, including shutter speed, focusing, and white balance. But if you take your ISO above 6400, all of these functions will be grayed out and shutter speed will be limited to 1/15th of a second. So keep your ISO to 6400 or lower on the P30 Pro. To get a good shot, if you're using the Huawei, I've found using the ×1 camera is best. I'll change the ISO to 6400, the shutter speed to 30 seconds, the autofocus to manual, and the white balance setting to tungsten, which is that light bulb logo. Make sure the flash is off, as that probably won't reach the stars and back in time for your camera to soak up that light, and then switch the self timer to at least 2 seconds. We're almost there now, but you just need to get your focusing right. You've switched it to manual focusing, so you need to get it in the right position. Get it all the way to the right, or if your phone is in landscape orientation like mine, all the way to the bottom of this slider. I sometimes play around with this to get it spot on, but usually all the way to infinity should be okay. Once you have your focus where you want it, take a shot. Now, if the shot is overexposed, raise your shutter speed or reduce your ISO. If it's underexposed, raise your ISO. But with these settings, you should get a good exposure of the stars. I'll normally change my shutter speed between 15 and 30 seconds, and then the ISO between 1600 and 6400. With the P30 Pro, the night mode only allows you to take the ISO up to 1600, which is very limiting, so Pro mode definitely is the best one to use. Once you have your settings sorted, you can then play around with your composition, getting different things in the foreground, like painting the foreground, or putting your car in the foreground, or anything that you can find in the location you're at. And this is one of the reasons why it's good to go scouting for locations in the daytime. You might find an old abandoned barn, a bridge, or a nice sand dune to put in that foreground. I was really surprised with the results I got from this camera, especially considering how small that sensor is, and again, considering it's a camera phone. I got a few different shots before the Milky Way had risen, and then once that came up, I got some shots of the Milky Way. It really did show the Milky Way nicely with those settings I've just talked about. I then brought this shot into Lightroom and edited it even further to make it pop even more. Now, it hasn't picked up the same amount of color as my full frame camera, but I was really surprised with how good the image was. I wouldn't want this as my main astrophotography camera, but if you do have this phone, it might be worth going out at night and giving it a go. You might be surprised with what you can get, and you never know, you might become addicted to astrophotography and end up getting a real camera. Now, have you tried astrophotography with your camera phone? If you have, let me know how you got on in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Photo Pills, the app that can show you the best conditions to go out in, click on this next tutorial here. And if you want to learn more about astrophotography, click on this link down here. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe for weekly tutorials in photography. I'll see you next time.